inspiration was a colleague, Tom Cox, when he was growing up in 1968. His mom and family were, you know, they were helping draft dodgers and deserters come across the border into Canada. They were Americans themselves. And so we heard lots of anecdotes and stories from Tom about that and decided that that would make a good television series. It is difficult to write. I mean, it's difficult to put yourself in the shoes of someone who's under that much strain and is pushed that far to the edge and then bringing them back. But that's the core of, I think, of good drama, you know, is finding people who are under great stresses and seeing how they respond and what they do.
What happened in the Vietnam War, so many injustices and so much corruption is happening now. And so as a society, I think we're embracing a lot of the notions that happened in the 60s, again now. All of the characters are complicated. This is something that I have always cherished as an actor, and it's so rare to find a writer who's talented enough to write complicated characters.
Finding a character that complex and that much depth to him and all the layers that he has going on is, I think it's a pretty rare thing to find. You know, I think it's a really exciting show. There'll be some thriller aspects, some spy aspects to it, definitely drama, some love interest. There's a little bit of everything. I honestly think there's someone for anyone to tune into.
I really hope when people see Fortunate Son that the parallels strike them. The current political situation worldwide, but particularly in the States, is it kind of is mirrored in 1968 in the story that we're telling. I hope people think about that when they watch it. And I hope they're entertained. Like, I hope they get caught up in the story and they like these people that we're building. And I think we have such an incredible group of people making this show, like actors, but also our crew, and our sets are out of this world. So I hope people are just like eating up the scrumptiousness.
What would our world look like? So how would we create the world that is 1968 in Canada? The story sort of takes the foreground, right? Where it's all just stepping into the Howards' life and into their home and into Ted's work and into the bank and the town of Ladner, and just a world that feels natural.
In the world full of kind of corruption and where revolution is around the corner, and he wants to be part of it. You know, he wants to bring change and good and positive in the world. So it's really great to, you know, defend this kind of character with these kind of ideas, because I kind of share them today, and it's not very far, even though it's, you know, 50, 60 years ago, it's still very, you know, relatable in today's society.
For me, it's like reflecting on like my parents' lives at that time, because they were in their 20s, and my character, this you know, weird to wrap my head around, would be I'd be my grandfather's age. The era of that, the 60s, what it represents and what survived it and what didn't. And I feel like we've taken a sharp turn away from that thinking, and we kind of need to find some of that thinking again now. It's hard to do, so it's good to have, it's good as an actor to be reminded